an easy one to do is come through like that, okay? Bring it out, smack him, even control the head here. If I wanna go vertical, fine. An extension, we do an extension is usually here. Smash the teeth. Whoop, bang, take that one out even. When we do it, it's up to you, right?
About to do a Canada and US tour. I'll be in Baltimore, LA, TM, which is MTSU, that area, Nashville, around the Nashville area, Murfreesboro. And also, obviously, up in Montreal and Toronto. Now, I'll be teaching a few Karambit seminars this time. Now, some of the questions I've been getting is, you know, what type of Karambit are you going to be teaching? One question I just got was, is it going to be, what was it, Kali or Filipino? I'm like, bruh, Kali is Filipino, okay? And if I was them, I wouldn't be so caught up on, you know, what type or what style. It's more about the tool itself. Okay, so my point of this seminar is sharing the information and the knowledge about what the Karambit is, not where it comes from and the lineage and how mystical we can be with it and teach you all this cosmic shit. I mean, I live in Japan, I speak my fourth language every day for business alone. If you want to get lost in that, we can. But what's more important is understanding the realistic and logical considerations and impacting factors involved with actually implementing such a tool. For example, what type of Karambit do you carry if you're allowed to carry? And if you do carry, what comes with that lifestyle? As in terms of what responsibilities do you have? And like I said, considerations. Are you, like, you know, when we carry a weapon, for example, we don't carry it to kill somebody. We carry it not to be killed. We carry it to survive. So even little things like this, push dagger like that, which I just did a review on, you can see on our online learning center and previews on YouTube here, you know, things like that, we use smaller things for efficiency, like less is more, and logical placement, concealment, deployment, even down to gripping, how you're going to grip, why you're going to grip like this, when you attack, when you do certain things, why you do it certain ways. A lot of places will just teach the what. You know, I'm going to do this drill, this hand goes here, this hand does this, and this is blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, why? Okay, not just what and how, but why? When, where? The who is obviously the adversary, the threat, the bad guy, the opponent, whatever it may be. But, you know, if you're not allowed to carry this and you're not going to carry this on the regular as part of your lifestyle for self-protection or self-preservation, then you're learning it as an art. You're learning a martial art, which is fine. I do martial arts, I teach martial arts, I teach Kali and Silat. The style of Kali that I teach is Filipino Combatives Global under Tuhon Felix Cortez. Silat, I teach raw Silat, which is a concept that I share based on my last decade of living in Asia and constantly traveling throughout there. If you want to just see my videos, you can see by how I move and what I do and what I'm saying. It's very logical, obviously. So it's more so for Westerners that are implementing this into our lifestyles, be it for self-protection or martial concepts that we can train without being lost in technique land or cultural customs or even religious sort of cult-like stuff, as there is a lot of that. So what I am doing is sharing not just information and knowledge, but skill. So as I said, information, knowledge is one thing. People say that knowledge and power is everything, but I believe that possessing the actual skill to get yourself out of a really bad or shitty unwanted situation is more important than knowing about, you know, the philosophical side of this, that, and the other. That's cool, that's great, that's martial arts, I respect the culture. And as I said, here in Japan, we do train other Southeast Asian martial arts such as Silat and Kali and so on. What I'm going to do is quickly introduce to you a couple of different types of karambits that we use, because this one, for example, this wooden one, is something we do a lot of drills with, but also we do train life blade. Now, we've got two different types of life blade. These come with different holsters and neck knives, and you can put them in different various places. But that is a single blade. That blade is just on the outside. You've got some that are on the inside. Depending on the style and all the master or people's personal fucking preference, what I've come across in Malaysia and Indonesia a lot of the time, I can't remember which time I was in Malaysia, it's probably about 3 or 4 years ago, one master I met had one that was like just a piece of wood and a little spike coming out the end, because a lot of the time in Silat we train the invisible blade through. We don't take it out and show them what we're doing, you know, hey, I've got a weapon, back up and whatever, that's bullshit. If I take a weapon like this bad boy out, which I particularly like, it's a double-edged blade, probably highly illegal where you're at, but anyways, You know, I've made the decision that this fucker needs to die. It's not a, hey, check out my knife, go to an eBay on special, whatever. No, look, this is, I'm taking it out so that I survive. This is a last resort. This is self-preservation. It's survival mode, beast mode on, if you want to put it that way. And look, this is not a game. You're not playing games, you're playing for keeps. And like I said, you carry such things to prevent yourself from dying. So survival, like I said, it's not to kill people. So the lifestyle, the mentality, the way that you train, like I said, the how is very important to remain aware of. And your sort of, how can I say, considerations and priorities more so, more importantly, your priorities have to keep in, have to stay in check. Okay, so we've got a few different types, folders like this. I'm just using cheap little ones to demonstrate a couple of different things. If you have something too big, it can be unrealistic, unpractical, especially if you're in a cold area like Canada. You also got to look at how that clip goes on, where you're going to put it, where you're going to conceal it, how you're going to conceal it. You got to train for that deployment, ripping it out, getting into the fight, and using it with efficiency. So minimum effort, maximum effect. So, you know, I've just done a review for our online learning center and a couple of reviews here on YouTube. And you can see, you know, how and why and what I'm choosing and why I'm choosing and why I'm recommending certain types of, you know, weapons and different things here, different tools for their various uses and merits or good points. So that's basically the gist of the raw Karambit seminar that I'm going to be teaching in Toronto, Montreal. Where else am I teaching that? At the Nashville area in Tennessee. And we might be doing a little bit in LA just yet. So look, what I want to say is, regardless of where it's from, whether it's fucking Malay or Indonesian or Filipino or whatever, it's like, look, I'm Australian, I live in Japan, we train martial arts and we train combatives, so that's how I'm going to be sharing it with you guys. So it's going to be, you know, I can show you some martial drills, some two-person drills, some applications, some jurus, some whatever ways that you can train this stuff in a lot of various methods and a lot of various concepts. It's up to you to choose what suits you and how you want to train it, you know, based on your goals, what you want to get out of your training, you know. So again, the most important thing is having that skill. So what I like to do with even martial training is show the combative application, make the transition or the translation even between martial and combative, because they are completely different. The objectives are different. Martial arts kind of take a long time, to put it very easily, to train a lot of sort of skills that are used where you wouldn't really use them in a combative sense in reality and on the street. For example, if you're the average Joe, if you're just a civilian, then you're not going to be having a priority of putting a lock on somebody and putting a strain on them and having them tap out or whatever, because that's not your role, that's not your position, that's not your goal. Okay, your goal would be to try and avoid and prevent that situation from happening first, and if and when it's no longer possible to exercise that option, then you might have to go hand to hand, and if and when you do, it's to, you know, finish that situation as soon as possible and remove yourself, get home to safety as soon as possible. So again, I want you to keep your sort of priorities in check, and remember that what I'm showing you or what I'm sharing with you on this trip is both martial and combative. So again, this is a martial arts weapon that has turned into a combative tool these days. Guys carrying these both concealed and exposed and whatever else, but in a lot of places they're becoming banned, you know. And there's a lot of excuses as to why, because they're dangerous, because this type of weapon, like the whole assault rifle thing, I mean, hey, it comes down to the person's intent. It doesn't matter about the weapon. So again, a lot of people think, you know, they've got this badass type Karambit here and they're like, yeah, this is a sick tool, this is a sick weapon, whatever. It's like, yeah, that's true. Look, that is very true. However, it's only going to be as good as you are. Okay, so if you're going to train, it's not just what you train, it's how you train. You've got to train for reality and keep your priorities in check, like I said. And I'm going to have to cut it off there because I'm running out of time and we are doing some tactical work today with weapon retention. So that's all I've got time for. If you want to learn more, even if you want a free preview of what the seminar is going to be like, you can check out our other videos on my channel. Or what you can do is get on the Online Learning Center and have a free week trial and check out all of our stuff from our SILAP, CQC, self-protection, armed threat management, we've got survival stuff, urban survival, everything. A lot of things, both combative and martial, that you can check out and see if it suits you. So thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, subscribe.